The world of real-time graphics and many stylized characters is still ruled by textured hair meshes and hair cards. Ornatrix provides many workflows to trivialize this, including handling the hair texture generation from dense hair on the fly. Let's explore this functionality. Open a scene containing a character with hair. The hair needs to be partitioned into groups. Refer to our group mesh tutorial on setting this up. Add a mesh from strands operator at the top of the stack and enable the group strands option. Note that we can generate two types of meshes: cylindrical groups encapsulating the grouped hair volumes, or flat ribbons. Adjust the side count parameter and note how the topology of the hair mesh changes depending on the current mesh type setting. Scroll down to Texture Generation section and choose a file path for the generated PNG texture. Click the Generate button to generate the texture. An alpha opacity hair texture is generated where each strand group is present as its own texture island. Note that you can change the bitmap size parameter depending on how detailed you want the texture to be. Now let's assign the standard surface shader to the hair. Give it a dark brown color and adjust parameters to resemble hair. In the Geometry section, enable Thin-Walled option and assign a new file texture as opacity. Select the hair PNG texture we generated earlier. Voila! You now have texture hair cards, which are procedurally linked to your hair geometry. If you don't see the texture, you may need to enable hardware texturing in the viewport shading settings. Go to Windows menu, Settings, Preferences. In the Files Project settings, scroll down and enable the Automatically Reload Updated Image Files option. This will be needed to reflect hair updates in our texture as you modify it. Go back to Mesh from Strand settings and change the mesh type option to Flat Ribbon. Click the Generate Texture button again to update the texture and see it in the viewport. Let's add a Rotate Strands operator before Mesh from Strands. Note how adjusting the global angle value allows you to orient the hair mesh strips. In Change Width operator, modify the thickness of the hair and regenerate the texture. Note how the hair thickness and shape are correctly preserved inside the texture. Try this workflow in your projects and see how Ornatrix can take the boring out of working with hair cards.